an educator, you have taught so many teachers, you have created so many teachers, and your name shines as one of the best top 10 teachers. So what, according to you, a teacher should focus while teaching? You just told that a child is observing teacher.
Yeah.
Okay. And different gesture, how teacher is speaking, what teacher is teaching. So what qualities can make a teacher a best teacher or a good teacher?
Right. First thing, we have to study maximum students, not books, because each student having different background. We don't know that student come from home to class. What is behind that? Whether that student ate breakfast or not. His or her stomach is filled or not. And you are asking questions and you are giving problems to solve this, all that. But whether that student is what about his background? And then you can start like that. As for it, because food is not there, nothing is possible to tell them. And we, I'm sorry to say, but it is a fact that whatever planning and syllabus and so many things, we are not going deeper in this aspect about the students. And naturally, the students also observe us. And as you told about the teacher, I talked to a number of teachers, and teachers also observe you, because around 8 teachers completed PhD under me, and 8 are going on. So around 16 per students. I am taking 2 years, because there are number of PhD guides. They are 25, 50, they are awarding like that. No, we have to take care of our student. We have to ask, they guide them. And like that, one teacher asked me after awarding PhD, "Sir, I want to give you Guru Dakshina. What I have to give?" So I told her that I don't know how I behaved during these 3-4 years, good or bad. No, that is not my question. But how I behave with you as a student, my PhD student, and now you are doctor. Please continue that with your student. So that we need. See, because we have to take care of students, because students are there, that's why we are there. Simple thing, when we enter in office, any office, who is sitting? Boss is sitting. And we are standing. In class, who is sitting? Students are sitting. And we are standing. So who is our boss? Students are our boss.
Fantastic.
So this is a simple thing. Simple thing. They are our boss. We are, instead of I am teaching them, I learned so many things from my students. My student interacted, my girl student, my boy student, they interacted after class. So many things they interacted with me, their personal problem. They are very much confident that I am having solution. Unable to talk with you on this platform, public platform. Students and my girl students, my boy students, they are facing a number of problems, like during this corona also. Now I am not attached with the directly with the students. I am attached with the principals and my teachers. But from them also, we are getting feedback. I want to give one example. Because of corona, now there is a restriction of the guest on the marriages, right? 50 or 100 or like that. One college in Sion area in Mumbai, that teacher told me the particular community girl, her father want to marry her because she is a brilliant. So she came to teacher and told, "See ma'am, my father want to do my marriage during this lockdown period." So that teacher asked to that father, "Why you want to insisting her?" "No madam, wo kya hai, 50-100 hi bulane ka hai, to kharcha kam ho jayega, to abhi shaadi kar dete."
Oh.
In fact, abhi shaadi kiya to kharcha kam aayega.
Ha ha ha.
forget about that her talent, forget about other things, how to develop. Kharcha kam aayega isliye bhi shaadi kar dega. You never heard this type of example?
Amazing. Yes.
So this type of things are going on, and my request to my all teachers, and they are also very happy with me, because all we are colleagues and doing so many implementing projects. So maximum we have to give love to them, they will give you back with the students, with the teachers. And many teachers told me your figure is parentally figure, fatherly figure for us, like that. So naturally each teacher is like that. Only thing, we are having limitation, because we are working in urban area, we are working in rural area, we are working in tribal area. So different types of exposure and learning and getting knowledge from them. So one example I can give you, one more, that one village I went, and I told my that teachers, a student of there is only two rooms for four class, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, half room by them, other class, like that in rural areas, interior rural. So I asked them whether you seen any laboratory. I studied in a school in Mumbai having a big laboratory, botany laboratory, then zoology laboratory, physics is there, chemistry is there. Then one girl stand up and he asked, sir, please tell me the name of that tree outside the school. I don't know why the particular birds are sitting on that tree only, not other, that I don't know. So she explained that tree giving small fruits, that particular birds are coming there to eat that fruits, small fruits, that's why the birds say. So that is our laboratory.
Absolutely,
that we don't
this know. Is really fantastic. So Dilip ji, recently this year during lockdown period, our honorary prime minister has announced the new education policy. So what change or transformation do you think it can bring to today's student? How far it will be fruitful in giving a better education to current generation who is right now in the school?
Yeah, it is earlier we pass out in 10+2+3 pattern, SSC, then junior college and then senior college. But now that is a 5+3+3, like that pattern is there, so +4. So it is very good pattern, and more focus of NEP is on professional education, because the students after 10th or during their school education, they are getting works on experience. So hands on experience they are getting. Then what I told you during the semester pattern, they have to work. There is a tie up with the industry, skill development entrepreneurship ministry is there, and you will be surprised to know that the National Skill Commission giving more grant compared to HR ministry to skill and entrepreneurship ministry. Even in state government also we are having a entrepreneurship and skill development ministry. So through that ministry, each college, degree college, they are getting around 5 crore rupees to start innovation and incubation center. That is very much important. The college is from art, science, commerce, but any student, any faculty, they can come there, they can sit, and as per their mind, forget about syllabus, forget about their degrees, as per their mind they can work on that any project. That is a initiative taken by this national education policy also. And more stress giving on the hands-on experience. That is a good thing in national education policy. And because we are having, you see, plenty of MBAs are there, but we don't have maximum number of supervisors. If you visit a mall, shopping mall, you are getting MBAs, you are getting the salesman, at counter, but the gap or lacuna between the MBA and the salesman, those who are doing college or completed 12, like that, the gap supervisory cadre people are very much needed. And that is important, because if we started, and because of national education policy, that gap government want to fulfill at additional knowledge with the degree, additional knowledge of that skill for retail management people, diplomas or degrees, even after, suppose you want to leave a graduation course in between. There are thousands of girls leaving half degree colleges, but they don't have any degree because they are not completed their schedule, 3 years course. Now there will be 4 years. So, but in this new education policy, you will get diploma if you complete 1 year. If you completed 2 years, you will get advanced diploma. And if you completed 3 years, then you will get degree. So because of age, because of social background, because of economical condition, particularly women, they have to listen to their families and parents. And they are losing their education life, their qualification, even though they completed 2 years, second year, SYBA, they qualified as, they have been mentioned as a 12th standard. Even they work for 2 years. So this is the main thing, and many education institute will be beneficial for this. And at the same time, the industry is also getting people, skilled people, what we can say, half skilled people for their factories. And through interns, they will get labor force while they are completing the education with the labor force, and win-win situation. Industry will get people, manpower, and students will get idea after graduation, this side is good for me, this side is not good for me. Because for example, by looking, seeing the films and this serials, many thousands and students, boys and girls, they want to become an advocate. Because in a movie, what they seen, either advocate is climbing the series or coming down or going up with the court and like that. At the same time, there are number of advocates earning in lakhs per day in India. Mm-hmm. So they are attracted to that career. But after getting degree in, after getting that degree in law, when they come at the court level, then they see the advocates are running behind the auto to get the client for what, for that agreement, or for just for stamp paper or like that. Then they fed up, but 5 years gone, they told, no, this is not for me. Like that, you see some artist, they complete their MBBS. And then they work there, and they fed up with the, no, we don't want to do medical education. We are the good paint. We know good painting. We are actor, right? That about this Sushant Singh, he was an engineer.
Yes.
Right? He left that and he came. But at the same time, when we are talking about the IITs, you can go for, there are thousands or lakhs of parents are behind their children to get admission in IIT. But at the same time, you can check the dropouts of IIT. Per year, 2,700 dropouts of IIT. Why? What are the reason? Why they dropouts? When they dropouts, means they are not interested. Because there is so much pressure from the family and the parents and the status symbol. My son is in IIT, my son is doing engineering, my girl is doing medicine. And at the same time, when you are dropping one seat, you are killing one new engineer, those who are on waiting list.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So these things, we never use that. We never think. The teachers and the parents, They have to think whether it is really my son attitude is really for the medical, really for the engineering. Like that, we seen that movie also, no? I forgot the name.
Tare Zameen Par.
Tare Zameen
Par. Three idiots.
Yes. Because last 31 years I am teaching in this field, I have seen. And that is the duty of teachers. And about the national education policy is a good solution on this. Good solution. But only thing about how to create good teachers, that is a main solution. Because policy is good, but at implementation level, we need a good people. Those who want to come for this, when you mention about the best teacher award, I received among the 10 best teachers in world, and as per the fellowship, I went to Kenya, Nairobi to teach the students there. And after 3 months teaching, they told me, no, you have to be here. We will give visa, everything, all facilities, everything in 2004. I told, no, sorry, I don't want to continue. I will come once in a year to teach your students and teachers, but I want to take care of my country student and new generation. So I came back from there. So every year I'm going abroad, no doubt about it. I was in USA for last continuous 3 years, and they offer me board of directorship, and I'm representing ASEAN USA for this community development society. So that type of, they are also very much interested in Indian education system. So now we are collaborating some programs, various around 15 countries I visited. I've seen the education policy. Why they want Indian students? Because they are saying that is a business. How business? First number is drugs, second is weapon, and third is education. Whatever fees, hum log jo paise bharte hai, MBA ke liye, Australia jane ke liye, US jane ke liye, it is a 10 times more than the local students. And India is the only country I've seen, you can correct me, the Indian parents will take a loan from banks and sending their child to abroad. And that is a good thing. My daughter is also at Vancouver in Canada. She is in instructional designing. She got a gold medal from SNDT, and she is learning more instructional designing. So I told her, okay, you do it, take education, take PhD, and come back after 5 years or 10 years. Because India is waiting for you. This is our motherland. We need a good teacher, we need a good students. And it will be new education policies, no doubt, which will be helping us for that this type of skill education, then vocational education. You seen our honorable prime minister did number of hundreds of collaboration with the Japan, and Japan is known for a world best country in technology. So there are technology we are hiring, we are taking their technology, but what about the grassroots level technician? So through the internet and all these things, they are ready to teach us. There are more demand in Japan for Indian students. But we have to open the criteria, because many people going to USA, then Canada, Australia, New Zealand, medicine for Russia, like that, and UK. But for Japan also, we have to learn Japan, Germany also, we have to learn Germany. So at least one language we have to learn, and we have to go abroad and come back, like many, many are doing like that. So that is my request to all my teachers. And there are a number of things we can discuss about the projects, like lifelong learning extension. We are having a projects of different scheme, and because of our projects, they when I joined as a director that time in 2006, 20 colleges with 2000 students. So because of student of rural development, I visited from Goa border, Gujarat border, around 750 kilometers each talukas in 7 districts. And I just explained, what is this extension? Whatever you are learning, you have to give back to the society. Then you will ask how. Each subject having extension. For Devgad, you know Hapu Sam Mango of Devgad. In that college, the MSc student, they in their MSc chemistry, they have a practical of soil testing. They have to test the soil. So I told them, okay, you complete your syllabus. In addition, whatever soil you are taking, so each student can collect soil from the 10 farmers' farm. Then that 50 students into 10. Just you can see how many farmers get report of their soil. And then the crop is depend on the soil. Like whatever blood report we are getting, on that basis, we are treatment is there. About the soil, they started like that. This is extension. One college in Dadar, they are taking these their equipments on Sundays. Physics laboratory, physics teacher taking equipment to and going to village near Virar, Safaya village, and they are explaining that practical, how to handle instrument, how to do practical in physics. Because they are the college teachers and Sunday lab is closed. So that instrument they allowed, the principal allowed to take them. Because in schools, they are having limited resource. And the whatever equipments are there, that is in the glass cupboard. And they return, don't touch. Because toot jayega. Like a library, books, phat jayega, padho mat, dekho khali. So this attitude we have to change.
Absolutely, right? Absolutely, Dr. Dilip. Now, as we are running short of time, so now I'm diverting from your career to Dr. Dilip Patil as a person, as a family man, as a father. So Dilip ji, tell us something about your family.
My wife, she is also a PhD holder in rural development. And she was also teacher, but because of taking care of my bedridden mother for 13 years, I lost my mother in 2015. She resigned from job and took care of my mother. And written around 5 books on rural development. I also wrote around 15 books on rural development for Mumbai University distance education students. Those who are doing correspondence, we wrote in English and Marathi both. And she is a homemaker supporting us. Whatever I am running here and there and various countries, and because of NAC member all over India and so many things. So the back office, my home, is more energetic. That's why I succeed in various programs, and I'm talking with my teachers also, my students also, and naturally someone is there behind you. You have to take like that. And my daughter, I told, she is doing PhD in Vancouver in British Columbia Institute of Technology. And my son, he is in 13th standard. He is doing bachelor in computer application. And my daughter was a gold medalist in rifle shooting, Mumbai University. And she completed her Bharatanatyam Arangyatram after 9 years of training, and Kala Sadan, her institute. And this additional knowledge is very much important. I told all my students that you have to add that. And she knows she completed a Spanish 5 level during this, all these things. And my son, he is a black belt karate champion, gold medal India, and he's a silver medal Bombay rifle shooting. And he completed military training for 3 years in 7, 8, 9 standard. And then last 3 years, he's doing NCC air wing from Jahim College, and cycling, football, like that. They are busy in that because this additional knowledge, even they not achieve the 75%, 80%, 60% is okay. But in addition, all these things are very much work in their life. How to talk with people, how to behave with that. So that is very much important thing that I feel this is a more thing. So we are having
you are setting a great example as a parent in front of all the parents of current generation, because nowadays parents, they have developed a competition kind of thing. They tell their children that okay, see, uska bachcha to 70% la raha hai, aapka kyun nahi aa raha, uska 90% aa raha, aapka bhi 90% aana chahiye. If he is a doctor, aapko bhi doctor banna chahiye. Main doctor nahi bana beta, to you have to become a doctor and fulfill my dream. So they are forcing their dreams on their children. Whereas I can see, as a father, as a parent, you and your wife, both have given an open space to your children to grow. So that is really, really commendable job you have done as a parent. So hats off to you, Dr. Dilip. And I'm really, really feeling so happy to meet such a parent who has actually defined the term parenting in real sense. You, as I am a parenting coach also, and I always counsel parents on making their parenting effective and graceful. Because nowadays it is more required that you do the parenting in a graceful way instead of just putting a slap or, you know, you taking a scale in the hymn. So you are setting a great example even as a parent too. So now coming to you as a person, how do you spend your me time? What are your hobbies? Now, what is the first thing you love to do when you get free?
Getting free time is very difficult for me. in one line, you see this black board. Can you read this?
Yes, it's a university logo is there. Yes.
And below the logo, what is written there?
Reach to unreached.
That is my hobby.
Oh, that's great.
That is my hobby.
You are serving people as your hobby, and that's why that passion is there to reach each and every person to the grassroots level. You're working as grassroots level, and you're reaching to each and every corner where you can reach to people to improve and to uplift them. So that's really great. Now, what will be one message would you like to give to all the parents out there who are watching this episode?
I'm not a big person to give message, but whatever I shared that, so we have to give importance to our children, not only to them, we have to help others. Always, whatever it is, when the salesman come to our door or courier wala is our at our door, and when I went to market, I asked them what you are doing, what is your qualification, and then they will ask me, sir, हम लोग का इतना 12th हो गया, 10th fail हो गया, आगे करने का क्या करने का है? तो पहले then I will guide you. These are the things. एंड ऐसे ऐसे जो लोग हमारे आजू बाजू में रहते हैं उनको ही हम लोग अभी जो कोरोना में जो इम्पैक्ट आया, कोरोना का इम्पैक्ट का एक एग्जाम्पल बता देता हूँ. मैंगो बहुत अच्छा था, बढ़िया था, लेकिन फार्मर के लिए मार्केट नहीं था. सो माई सन एंड माई सेल्फ वी कलेक्टेड अराउंड 100 बॉक्सेस फ्रॉम देवगढ़ एंड वी सोल्ड इट हियर. सो पीपल आर रेडी टू बाय. So like that, we have to help others, okay? And returns, we don't want anything. No loss, no profit, which only satisfaction, whatever we received or some blessings we received from them, that is more workable than the money. So that's why always my message is like that. Whatever things you are getting, that you have to always help to them, help to others. Help means not only by money, you can guide rightfully, whatever as I expected, you can, they want some guidance and you have to give it as per your knowledge. Or I don't have any knowledge, I can refer Abha Jadhav. Okay, this lady, she knows better than me about in her field, so please go to her. Like that we can do it, right? And naturally, when we took care of our parent, as I told you, so my children are looking to us. In their mind, they think how to take care of parents, right? So that way we are unselfish. So उनको मालूम पड़ा कि parents का कैसे टेक केयर लेना चाहिए. बराबर ना? दैट इज सिंपल थिंग.
एक रिलेशन है, अगर आज हम अपने बच्चों को अच्छे से केयर करेंगे, उन्हें एक अच्छी परवरिश देंगे, तो डेफिनेटली कल को जब हम बूढ़े हो जाएंगे और हमें उनकी केयर की जरूरत पड़ेगी तो वो जरूर हमें केयर करेंगे. वरना क्या होगा, आज हम अगर उनकी केयर नहीं कर रहे हैं तो हमारे बुढ़ापे में वो हमें छोड़ देंगे एंड वो कहेंगे कि पापा मम्मी आपने हमारे लिए तो कुछ किया नहीं, देन व्हाई यू आर एक्सपेक्टिंग फ्रॉम अस. So that is always,
and not only that,
yes,
they will think what you did for your father and mother.
Yes, they will also
then
see
what
that.
Will be our answer.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yes. They will also see that. So naturally, yes. Same. Yeah, we are not dependent.
Children always learn from observation. So when they are seeing, observing their parents, the way they behave with their parents, and the same way they behave with us.
Yes, yes, yes.
So it has been a great time knowing you, Dr. Dilip Patilji. Thank you for giving me this time from your busy schedule and making my this 50th episode of Spotlight with ABHA worth watching. So thank you very much for being here on this platform, and thank you for your valuable guidance to all the teachers, parents, and all the students out there. So thank you very much. And friends, you can watch this episode of Spotlight with ABHA on my YouTube channel, ABHA Jadhav. But for that, you have to subscribe my YouTube channel. So it's just below my video. Click that subscribe button and don't forget to hit the bell icon. And of course, you can listen to this interview on Radio Brain Rhyme, which has been broadcasted in more than 20 countries. And so for that, you have to download Radio Brain Rhyme application from Google Play Store. So what are you waiting for? Just take your phone, download Radio Brain Rhyme application from Google Play Store. So friends, we'll be meeting in next episode of Spotlight with ABHA with yet another interesting personality. Till then, give us permission to leave from this episode. Take care of yourself, take care of your children and teachers. Fasten up your belts. Now you have to become a better teacher with coming new education policy. So till then, goodbye. Take care. Namaste.